Hey guys, and a very 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 warm welcome back to my channel. So we are continuing with our series of internal security issues, and we have already covered many of the topics related to internal security. In the previous lecture we talked about various apparatus of internal security, and we have completed that topic. Now I'm coming back to the northeastern state, which I wanted to talk to you guys. And in the northeastern state, today we will be talking about interstate border disputes in northeastern states. Okay, so as I told you that in the northeastern states, within the states itself, there are many issues. Okay, and these issues has arisen due to many of the factors like different ethnicities, demographic, geography, political demarcations, and border demarcations and all. We have discussed all the factors in the one of the previous video. You guys can check that out. Okay, and let's now today talk about interstate border disputes in northeastern state. What are the disputes and why they are there? Okay, so before starting that, I would like to tell you, for all the people who are new to this channel, this side Avan Anjo, and you are here currently for free UPSC preparation. Okay, and the word free is very important because this is completely free for you guys. I'm not into any kind of taking money for providing education, because this is something I know and I would love to share it with you guys. Okay, also, just one thing I want from you guys is that just subscribe to this channel to give me more motivation to make these videos, and like if you liked it, if you understood it well, like it and share it with your friends who also need it. Just subscribe guys, because this is something which gives me motivation to know, and I could get to know that yes, you guys are getting benefited from this. Okay, as this is completely free and we are already talking about interstate border disputes in northeastern state, it is going to be very very completely in depth. You don't have to worry about the fact that if it is enough or not, if the knowledge is enough or not, and all of this is from pre plus mains point of view, pre cum mains point of view, you can say. Okay, we are talking about both of them. Okay, so now without any further delay, let's get started. So let me first of all give you a brief idea about the disputes. Okay, so we have already discussed the factors which have led to these kind of disputes. Okay, so after those disputes have arisen, so there are many of the incidents where these disputes have taken place. First of all, just give me a sec, I'll just change the color so that it's better visible. I hope it is now better visible. Okay, so there have been several attempts, there have been certain reoccurring incidents that happened for the disputes between the northeastern state. Very recently also, if you guys have seen in the news, that between Assam and Mizoram police personals, uniformed police personals, there was a clash, there was gun firing, and literally they used light machine guns. So you can just see the level of intensity. Okay, and around 20 of personals have also died. So these things suggest the intensity of these disputes, and these disputes are not something which is surfacial and which just came right now. They are very deep. They are deep from the time when there was border, the reconstruction of the northeastern states. The interstate borders have been made, and the borders, and this task was done in such a hurry that it became difficult for the people, like people who are living there. If there is a community, okay, and that community of people, they are together, okay, they have the same ethnic group, they are together, but during the time of demarcation of the interstate boundaries, all of their ethnicities, all of the demographic conditions in which people are living, everything was overlooked, and the borders were seen cutting through those ethnic groups. Okay, it divided the group into two different states. They just end up being in two different states, although it is the same group and they wanted to stay together in one state, but that border, it somewhere divided it. Okay, so it was a task which was done in hurry, and that is one of the reasons that there are a lots and lots of disputes relating to, you know, separation of, you know, there are separatist movement going on, insurgencies going on in some parts, there are militancies also, but if you talk about Northeast, so mostly there is insurgencies that are going on there, okay. So also there have been a collective failure of the respective state governments as well as the union government since the time being. I'm just not talking about the current times, but since the time being there have been independence and there has been a formation of federal policy. From that time till today, you know, there have been several attempts which have been made, but they have been completely unsuccessful to, you know, to get in touch with what is the problem and to resolve the issue, because that this issue is very, very deep enough, and we need to work, you know, very cautiously, and we need to work with our full awareness, attention, and looking at the consequences if this work is not done. Okay, it is going to lead to many, many different, very, very difficult circumstances for people. Okay, so all of these disputes that have arisen, the non-resolution of those issues or those disputes have led to things like community sentiments. Okay, community sentiments which are quite intense. Community sentiments, okay, which are quite sorry, there has been a bit of issue with my mouse. Just give me a sec. Yeah, so community sentiments. This has given rise to many of the community sentiments, and this has even furthermore violated the interstate relations between the communities, okay. And this has ultimately led to the internal security issues, okay, in northeastern states, and like issues like, of course, we talked about them, right, in the previous video as well. Issues like, sorry, but today my mouse is just giving me some problems. Insurgency. There have been, you know, increased levels of insurgency, okay, and there have been increased number of rebel groups as well. Okay, there have been more incidents which have been reported for criminal activities, criminals, increase in the number of criminals, and all of these are gaining now upper hand in the northeastern states. Okay, so this is a, you know, a big concern as far as internal security of India is concerned. Okay, this is actually the issue of grave concern. And all of these interstate stresses between different states of northeastern part of India, okay, there have been a very acute nature of disputes that are taking place, and these things are rising day by day. The increase in the number of disputes are there, okay. So I'll give you a brief idea about how much border, interstate border, is shared by the different states. So for that I would like to take you through the map. I hope guys this map is visible to you. So this is a very, very simple and, you know, a good map with different colors to differentiate. So this is a map of the, of course, you know, northeastern India, okay. So these are the various states within Northeast India, and let me tell you that how much borders are shared by which state. So I'm going to take the reference point as Assam, because it shares the border with all seven of them, okay. So Assam, and if you talk about, let's say, Assam and Mizoram, okay. So Assam and Mizoram, this is the border they share, and it is around 165 kilometers in length, okay. Then Assam and, let's say, Nagaland, okay. So Nagaland is very big border, okay. The length is very, okay, so it is around 434 kilometers in the border sharing, okay. Then we have Arunachal, okay. You guys can see Arunachal is, I think, the longest one. Not I think, but it's of course confirmed, it is the longest one. or maybe not. Let's see, wait. It is around 804 kilometers in length, and Meghalaya. Is even longer, that is around 884 kilometers. Okay, so why, like, this is 804 and this is 884. So of course, if you are just looking it like this, so you guys can see that, you know, if you are going to compare do the comparison between the both Meghalaya and Arunachal with respect to Assam, so if you look at it visually, so it is appearing that this is the longer border, but actually the thing is that, let me just remove this ink. You guys can see here that the lines are quite straight, okay, like not much curves and, you know, not much curves and twists are there. Whereas if you see this, okay, so it is just going like this, like curves and not a kind of a straight boundary. So this is what makes it increased, you know, in length. If you are going to just measure it like this, so the length is going to of course be longer, because if you are going to just take this part, like it is like this, okay, it is like this, and if you just open it, so it is going to be much longer than what it already is. It is like this, okay, so if you hold it, so it will not make much difference when you make it straight, okay. So this is the reason as why Arunachal's boundary is actually lesser than what is of Meghalaya. So we can say that Meghalaya shares the longest boundary with Assam. Okay, I hope this has been clear. So now, first of all, I would like to take the issue of Assam and Mizoram. Okay, so I would like to talk about issue or the issues which are there between the states of Assam, between the states of Assam and Mizoram. Mizoram. Okay, so let's talk about all the issues within this state. So when I talk about the issue, so recently also I told you just now that there has been a issue where there has been a like a brutal dispute, a brutal clash between the police personals of Assam and Mizoram. Okay. So why is it so that they had a dispute? So there are certain disputes related to boundary issues, okay. So as I already told you that Assam and Mizoram shares around 165 kilometers of boundary, okay, 165 kilometers of boundary, and there are three disputed areas within that boundary. First is the Kachar. I will show it to you through map also, don't worry. This is the Kachar district. Second district is Helakandi, okay, Helakandi, and last one is the Karimganj. Karimganj, okay. Now these three are basically the disputed areas. Let me show it to you through map so that you guys can get even more clarity. So there is a very, very nice map which explains you all the districts where they lie exactly, okay. So just a minute, yeah. So you guys can see that Assam is here, okay, this is Assam here, and Mizoram here, okay. So the issue, the areas of dispute in the Assam region are, as I already told you, these one, okay, the Kachar, the Helakandi and Karimganj, okay, Karimganj, Helakandi and Kachar. You guys can just see to the areas where they lie, okay, in the Assam, okay, this is the point where Kachar is there, this is the point where Helakandi is there, and this is the point where Karimganj is there, okay. Whereas when I talk about the disputed areas of Mizoram, so here only you can see, this is एजावल इज बेटर, एजावल. ओके, देन वी हैव कोलाजिब, कोलाजिब एंड मैमिथ. एजावल, कोलाजिब एंड मैमिथ. सो दीज आर द थ्री एरियाज वेयर द डिस्प्यूट इज रिलेटेड टू द बॉर्डर, बेसिकली बॉर्डर शेयरिंग डिस्प्यूट. ओके, एंड दीज आर द एरियाज विच शेयर द बाउंड्री, बेसिकली विच शेयर द बाउंड्रीज टूगेदर. ओके, एंड ऑफकोर्स द डिस्प्यूट्स आर लार्जर हेयर. ओके, बिकॉज देर इज अ बाउंड्री शेयरिंग विद इन दिस एरिया. नाउ यू कैन जस्ट सी दैट देर इज अनदर, देर आर सर्टन मोर नेम्स दैट आर गिवन, लाइक वेरांगटे, वेरेंगटे. सो इन द वेरेंगटे रीजन, विच इज लाइंग इन द, यू कैन जस्ट सी, ओके दिस इज कोलासिब, ओके दिस दिस होल इज कोलाजिब एंड इट इज लाइंग इन कोलाजिब. ओके, सो वेरेंजे इज लाइंग इन कोलाजिब, कोलाजिब डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड इट इज अ शेयर्ड बाउंड्री डिस्ट्रिक्ट कोलासिब. ओके, सो देर हैज बिन अ क्लैश बिटवीन टू स्टेट पुलिस पर्सोनल. दिस इज द प्लेस वेयर द क्लैश हैपेंड. ओके, फ्रॉम देयर साइड इट इज इन द कच्छर एंड फ्रॉम मिजोरम साइड इट इज इन कोलासिब. ओके, सो कच्छर एंड द कोलासिब वर द टू प्लेसेज वेयर दिस डिस्प्यूट फ्रॉम देयर रिस्पेक्टिव एरियाज. इट इज द पॉइंट वेयर दैट डिस्प्यूट हैपेंड. ओके, द रीसेंट विच आई टॉक्ड अबाउट, गिव मी अ सेक. Yeah, so a very recent issue that has happened, let us just talk a bit about it. Around 26th, not around of course, on 26th of July 2021 was the time when this issue has happened in the Werangje, Kolasib and Kachar of Assam. A clash between the two states police personnel has happened. Okay, why, what is the dispute? What is the dispute that is leading to all of these clashes? So the dispute here is basically Assam and Lusai Hill district. Assam and Lusai Hill. Lusai, L-U-S-H-A-I, Lusai. बोलने में Lusai होता है, but otherwise it's Lusai. You can just speak whatever you want to. But please just look at the pronunciation when you are going for your interview and all. So you need to just take care very much about the pronunciation of words you use. Okay, Lusai Hills and Assam. This is the region of actual dispute. Okay, what is the dispute? Let us just have a look at that. Let me just get you a map. Just wait a minute. So there is this beautiful slide I got from News 18 sources. Okay, so they explained you how old is this dispute. Okay, so I would like all of you guys to look at this. So the basic problem of dispute has been the two notifications that are at the heart of this dispute. Okay, so you guys can see that this is the area which is the disputed one, which I just talked about, and in around, you know, 1875 notification. Okay, the thing was that it differentiated the Lusai Hills. Okay, Lusai Hills, that is the former name of Mizoram before it became a state, from the plains of Kachar. Okay, so according to this notification, the Lusai Hills are not a part of Kachar of Assam. Okay, they have been differentiated, whereas not differentiated basically, but the thing was that the boundary was not there between the Lusai Hills, i.e. the Mizoram and the Lusai Hill region of Mizoram, or either you can say it is Mizoram or the Kachar. Okay, whereas in the 1933 notification, there has been a boundary between the Lusai Hills and Manipur. Okay, so the Assam government it wants to follow the 1933, that means this one notification, where they want to demarcate the Lusai boundary between Lusai Hill and Manipur. Okay, whereas the Mizos don't accept this, and the because the Mizo chiefs, okay, when this particular notification was given by the British India, so at that point of time the Mizo chiefs were not consulted about this boundary. Okay, and Mizos believe that this boundary should be demarcated on the basis of this one, that is the 1875 notification. Okay, this is their demand. What is the demand of Assam government? That it should be on the basis of 1933 notification. Okay, and this should be on the basis of 1875 according to Mizoram, and this is according to Assam. Okay, so this is what is the point of contention. You have got it. Okay, now there was okay, something I would like to talk about 1875 notification. 1875 notification. When I talk about 1875 notification, so it was brought through Britishers through BEFRA. Okay, BEFRA is basically an act. Okay, and the name is Bengal Eastern Frontier Regulation Act. Okay, Bengal Eastern Frontier Regulation Act. Okay, according to this, they published a ILP. ILP is Inner Line Permit. Okay, they give a Inner Line Permit. Okay, for the three northeastern states. Okay, the Inner Line Permit is required if you want to cross the interstate boundary. So you need to have that permit. Okay, that is known as Inner Line Permit, and that permit is valid for three places, that is Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh, and Mizoram. Okay, and recently, around 2020, recently, Manipur has also been added into the needing for this permit. This permit is still going on. Okay, Mizoram is also added. Okay, so the permit still exists. It has been introduced by Britishers through BEFRA, that is Bengal Eastern Frontier Regulation Act, and ILP is the Inter Line Permit that has been issued by them for these three states initially, and then afterwards in 2020 it has been issued for Mizoram as well. Okay, have you guys heard about a very very famous festival that is known as Hornbill Festival? Where it is celebrated? Just answer it to yourself, or you can write in the comment box also, where is Hornbill Festival celebrated? I want you all to write this down in the comment section below, and we'll see who gives the right answer. Okay, so a Hornbill Festival is very very popular festival. You can read upon that also, and you need to know that where it is celebrated. And another question for you is, do we need ILP for that? So of course, in the question itself, I've given you answer that it must be from these four. Okay, because I have talked about ILP, so you need to get to know also that is ILP required for that particular to enter during Hornbill Festival for that particular state. Okay, I'm just specifically saying during Hornbill Festival, if I want to go and watch the Hornbill Festival to that particular state, so do I need the ILP? So you this is your task. Just write in the comment box below and let's see if you know about it or not. And if you don't know, it's completely fine. Just go through it, you'll get to know new things. Okay, just don't take things something positive. Either it's going to give you a positive result or either it's going to give you a negative result. Okay, there is no negative in learning. Just make sure you will, even if you're writing and even if it is wrong, then you'll get to know about the right thing. And even the thing is that, you know, it has been proven by psychologists that, you know, if you're going to learn through failure, so that is going to stick in your mind even better. Okay, so whenever next time, if in some exam you are giving, if they are asking you this particular question, so you would know that Okay, so this was a time when in the advance video we saw she asked her a question and we answered, but my question was wrong. Okay, and I looked at the other comments and I got the answer. So that is going to even give you a better, you can say, what do we say? Okay, छाप पड़ जाती है जैसे. It is inside your mind. It is imprinted deeply. And you will know about it. If you would have given the right answer, so you may have not retained it, okay? या फिर आपने तुक्का लगा दिया, तो अभी तो तुक्का सही बैठ गया, बट पेपर में आपको याद ही नहीं रहेगा आपने तुक्का क्या लगाया. लेकिन आपने तुक्का नहीं लगाया, वो गलत हुआ, लेकिन आपने ट्राई किया, ठीक है, तुक्का भी लगा दिया, चलो ठीक है, लेकिन वो गलत हुआ, ठीक है, सही हुआ तो याद नहीं रहेगा, लेकिन अगर गलत होके सही कोई चीज़ पता लगी है तो वो आपको याद रहेगी. सो दिस इज समथिंग विच इज एडवांटेजियस. ओके, एंड एक और चीज़ मैं बोलना चाहूँगी कि डोंट लुक एवरी थिंग थ्रू द प्रिज्म ऑफ नेगेटिव और पॉजिटिव. दिस इज समथिंग आई लर्न इन माई लाइफ, दैट इफ यू आर लुकिंग एट समथिंग थ्रू अ प्रिज्म, बेसिकली द इफ दैट प्रिज्म, ओके, इफ दैट प्रिज्म इज ऑफ नेगेटिविटी, इफ यू आर जस्ट हैविंग अ परस्पेक्टिव ऑफ नेगेटिविटी, सो everything that is going to, if you are going to look it from this place, if you are looking from this place, okay, then the world, however it is going to appear to you, is going to be negative one. And if your prism is a positive one, okay, if you know that, yeah, even if I made a mistake, I'm going to learn through it. If you are going to look from this perspective, so you are going to get a beautiful world. You're going to look at a beautiful world, and this is not something that is just there for the sake of doing it. World is not that negative, okay? You just need to have a look within and just understand your powers, your strength, your limitations. If you could work upon it very well, if you couldn't work upon it, like certain physical limitations, so accept it and move on, because that's the only thing you can do. And try to go through your own self. Instead of going out and changing the world, first you have to change yourself, and then what you're going to vibe around and the world outside is going to change. You don't have to do anything for that. It is going to change on its own. Okay, and sorry I just went so deep into the topic, but this is something that is important for your personality building as well. Okay, as I told you that we'll be having certain personality sessions also. So I'm just thinking of doing one today where I'm going to talk about the perspectives and a bit philosophical. Sometimes it goes into spiritual, a bit of it also, because that is something that is needed, yaar. Okay, and I'm just not going to touch upon that right now. Let's come back to our topic, and I'm going to make a video on that. Okay, and I'm going to discuss everything. Okay, and you just give it a thought, okay, and introspect upon that. I hope that is going to help you. Okay, we'll be coming up with more videos like that, don't worry. So coming back, 1875 ILPs, I suppose it is clear to you. Okay, so this ILP, okay, so ILP, as I already told you, that the Indian citizens who are not the domicile of that particular particular state, they are not allowed to do the interstate movement, and only after seeing a ILP from an authorized competent authority, you are allowed to do the interstate border movement. Okay, so this is what ILP was all about. Let me okay. So intention for this ILP by the Britishers was they thought that every culture within the Northeast, every culture is very unique and it is very close to their heart. Okay, also from their economic perspective, from their money minded perspective, that area was very resourceful as well. Northeast was very resourceful for them, so they don't want any kind of disputes to happen. That's why they introduced ILP, so that in order to avoid conflicts, if people are not doing much of the movement within their community, so they are not going to go through disputes. So this was their major philosophy or major mindset behind this ILP. Okay, so I told you about all of this dispute. Okay, we discussed about this notification part, and there is this dispute of Lusail Hills in either being in Assam or either being in like Manipur, Mizoram. So that was the basic dispute that was there. Okay, so there has been many clashes. Okay, as I already told you, already like clashes are happening so frequently. If I could just trace back to 2006, then it happened in 2018, and then very recently again there has been a clash between Assam and Manipur. Assam and Mizoram I'm only talking about. Okay, so happened. Okay, so you can just see. And even 2021, a very recent one. Okay, the July 26, 2021, very brutal and a very worse kind of dispute. Okay, so this was all about Assam and Mizoram. Okay, we still have time, so let me cover up the Assam and Nagaland as well. We'll cover Assam, Arunachal, Assam, Meghalaya, all of the disputes, and we'll just also look at the solutions. And then I would just give you a brief history of insurgency in Nagaland, because that is a place that is having the highest amount of insurgencies currently. So, and it also is the most prominent in Nagaland. The insurgencies are most prominent in Nagaland. So I'm just going to give you a in-depth history about those insurgencies. Why are they happening? What was the reason? Okay, and everything, and solutions, of course. Okay, so now let me give me a sec. Let me introduce some new slides here, because I'm just out of slides. Yeah. Okay, so great. So let us now start our discussion on Assam. I don't know why I call it Assam. I don't know where is this accent coming from. I don't know. Nagaland, Assam, Nagaland, Assam, Nagaland dispute. Okay. So let us talk about Assam and Nagaland dispute. So as I already told you that I'm going to discuss about the history afterwards, okay, but I'll tell you the agreement. There has been an agreement. And that agreement was signed between NNC and Governor of Assam. Okay, the Governor of Assam during the time of the agreement was Akbar Haidri, and this agreement was called a 9-point agreement. We are going to have a in-depth discussion about what was this agreement and how we came to sign this agreement, what was the circumstances that has led to this agreement. Okay, so this is a very important agreement. Just note this down properly. So this is the 9-point agreement that was signed between NNC and the Governor of Assam, who was Akbar Haidri. Okay, then after this 9-point agreement, there has been, in the time of around 1960s, there has been the advanced version of this agreement that was called 16-point agreement. 16 point agreement. Okay. So NNC is from Nagaland, and this is basically between Nagaland and Assam. Okay. And this 16 point agreement basically demanded a separate state of Nagaland. Okay. Earlier it was a part of Assam. So through 16 point agreement, they have asked for a separate state of Nagaland. Okay. So the most disputed territories of Nagaland and Assam are two of them. First one being Nagaon, Nagaon, Nagaon. Second one being Golaghat. Golaghat. These are the most disputed territories of Assam and Nagaland. Okay. In 1968, there has been a violent clash. Okay. And between, of course, Assam and Nagaland, and a committee was prepared, a committee of Justice K. Sundaram committee. Justice K. Sundaram committee. It was constituted after this 1968 clash. This was constituted in around 1971. Okay, and they were asked to just research upon it, and their according to this committee, they were asked to maintain the status quo. According to the report, it was asked to Nagaland and Assam to maintain a status quo. Okay, then. Then in 1979, a major violent clash, it happened involving the citizens. Citizens were involved in that clash, and the major step, okay, again a clash happened. Okay, so a major step was taken by the government, okay, where they have given the emergence to DAB. DAB, full form is disputed. This is D, disputed area belt. I'm writing with a mouse, so it gets difficult to write, but I just make sure that it is legitimate enough so that you guys can know. And I'm speaking at the same time, so if you are not able to make out what I'm writing, just listen to my voice properly and you can just write the words. Okay. And if I feel there is a need to give out the spelling as well, so I'll do that also. So disputed area belt is DAP. Okay. And it was like approximately around 10 kilometer wide belt. Okay. And it was in two districts of Assam, that is in the Golaghat and Jorhat, Jorhat, Jorhat. Okay, these areas under DAB, they were declared as neutral areas. Meaning of neutral areas is that they are not under any of the state. Okay, they would be maintained by the central security forces. Okay, and they are neutral areas, i.e. they do not lie in any of these two states, Assam and Nagaland, okay? Because they are the disputed areas, okay? And there has been already been so many clashes, okay, to get this area. That's why this was done, okay? So in this neutral areas, the security, central security forces have been deployed, like Assam Rifles, okay, and CAPF, Central Armed Police Forces, other CAPF forces were deployed, and there was no role for state police in DAV, no state police. Now to me, you know, you need to know this, it was fully in control of center, so no state police can come and, you know, do something or, you know, get deployed there. But even that arrangement of DAV, it didn't brought any good changes, okay, and the clashes continue to be there, violent clashes all, like if I'm talking about clashes, so they are tend to be violent because it was the nature from the beginning. In 1985, there was an incident called Meerapani, M-I-R-A, Meerapani, P-A-N-I, Meerapani incident, and the region, in the Meerapani region, it shows the intense, it actually experienced intense bloodshed, killings, and attempts to resolve was there, okay, so there were intense bloodshed and killings, very violent form. There has been an attempt to resolve this particular clash in the form of a commission that was called as Shastri Commission. But the reports that were given, the final reports that were given by the Shastri Commission were neglected by, or not neglected, the word is not right, they were rejected by Nagaland, okay? Like Assam still, you know, agreed to implement that, but Nagaland didn't approve of it, okay? Then again, this matter, particular matter, again in 1988, this matter, it reached to Supreme Court, okay, through the original jurisdiction. Even, you know, even Supreme Court could realize the, you know, realize this fact that while drawing the boundaries, the history, ethnicity were overlooked, which is basically leading to these conflicts that are there today. Okay. In 1995, the petition which was there in Supreme Court was taken back. The petition was taken back. Okay. In 1997, there was another commission that was appointed that was called as J.K. Pilani. Commission that was appointed, okay, and they did the survey on ground, okay, for this issue, but Nagaland was not accommodating. Then in the year I told you about the year, na? I told you about. Okay, so JK1, JK Plani was in 2004. Okay, then in 2010, the matter was again, you know, reaching to Supreme Court, and this time the Supreme Court ordered to form a local commission. Supreme Court ordered to form a local commission this time. Okay, just give me a sec. There has been some problems. I'll just tell you the timeline again from 1995, because there has been some there is a problem in mentioning of years. Okay, so 1995 the petition was taken to the Supreme Court. Then in 1997 the petition was taken back. Okay, main wahan se start kar rahi hu, main yahan se start kar rahi hu. The petition was taken back in 1995. Okay, then in 1997 it is the time when JK Pilani Commission was formed. But now it was JK Pilani Commission was formed and it was rejected by Assam. Their report has been rejected by Assam. And then in 2004 again the matter reached to Supreme Court, and this time they told to form a local commission. This time they ordered to form a local commission which will do the survey on ground, but Nagaland was not accommodating. Nagaland ne mana kar diya accommodate karne se. Now let us come to 2010 mein kya hua ki Supreme Court, they appointed their two senior advocates, naming two of them. One is Shriram Panchu, P-A-N-C-H-O-O, Panchu, and second one was Niranjan Bhatt. Okay, so they together mediated between Assam and Nagaland. Okay, both of them, they mediated between Assam and Nagaland to resolve the border dispute. Several rounds happened. Report was submitted which was rejected by both Assam and Nagaland. Assam and Nagaland both rejected that. Okay, what is the current situation? Currently in the DAB region, in the DAB disputed area belt region, Gaon Buddha, Gaon Buddha is basically to refer to the elders of that, they call head of the villagers, basically they are called as Gaon Buddhas. Okay, they are carrying out the negotiations, and they are basically making the decisions and all whatever is required, and still it is not a part of either Assam or Nagaland. Okay, so this is the issue in Assam and Nagaland currently, what is the disputes. Okay, now let us very quickly come to our two remaining ones and then we'll discuss the solutions. Assam and Arunachal. Assam and Arunachal, okay. Assam and Arunachal, there were certain anomalies or the disputes due to demarcation. Okay, so of course the process of demarcation is one of the basic issue. In 1951 there was a commission that was called as that was called as B-O-R, Bor, D-O, Bordoloi, Bordoloi, B-O-R-D-O-L-O-I. Bordoloi Commission was appointed. Bordoloi Commission was there, okay, and there was a notification of 1951 notification was released, which was rejected by Arunachal. It was rejected by Arunachal Pradesh. ठीक है, what was in this notification, that that is the 3648 square kilometer of area, okay, which is presently they are the three different districts. It represents the three different districts of Assam, which are Darlong, Darlong, or it is Darong, Darong, not Darlong, okay. Then we have Dimoji, Dimaji, and we have Jonoi, Jonoi, okay, they were transferred to Assam, okay, according to this notification. But why Andhra Pradesh rejected this? Because they have a very popular organization called NEFA, okay, and they said that they were not consulted about this notification. There was no agreement or no sahmati from their side. There were no consultations, okay. So this is the basic dispute. This was the basic dispute between Assam and Arunachal. Now let's come at Assam and Meghalaya. Okay, let us talk about Assam and Meghalaya. Longest border sharing is between Assam and Meghalaya. Okay, we already know it. So Assam and Meghalaya, the dispute is that the Assam Reorganization Meghalaya Act. Okay, so it was Assam Reorganization Meghalaya Act. ठीक है, ऑफ इट दिस एक्ट वॉज ऑफ 1965. ओके, सो इट वॉज बेसिकली एन एक्ट प्रपोज बाय असम विच वॉज रिजेक्टेड बाय मेघालय. ओके, एज पर अ डिसीजन दैट वॉज टेकन इन 12 पॉइंट्स, देयर वर 12 पॉइंट्स, ओके, which Meghalaya was not accepting. Okay, the disputed area, the total disputed area is around 2765 kilometers. So it is a very very large area that is disputed. Okay, then in 2011, mouse is just posing problems today, 2011, okay, Meghalaya Assembly has passed a resolution which demanded the intervention by the government of the Union government, and there was a constitution when the Union government intervened. So there was a formation of a commission known as Boundary Commission. Boundary Commission. It was constituted. Okay. to look at this area, but still there have not been any kind of major success and all for this. Okay, so it is somewhat still under the dispute. So we just talked about many of the different interstate disputes. Okay, and Assam being the central point, of course it is going to be a point of dispute because it shares border with all seven of them. So what is the possible solution? Let's discuss now the possible solutions that could be there. Okay, because you need to know the solutions as well. You just can't look at the problems. Okay, again that approach. You always should write solutions in your answers. So solution, of course, here there need this issue is very very deep and very very a big cause of concern. And what should be done is that first thing is that all the political parties should join their hands. Okay, and there should be a strong political will, and they have to have committed efforts, and they have to shape the public opinion of the people living in the Northeast. Okay, and they have to shape it in such a way that their opinion for a peaceful interstate border. Okay, so they have to shape their opinion for a peaceful interstate border. Okay, they will have to first, all the tempers that are going up, they should first of all reduce that. Okay, and they should spread awareness. I'm just writing some words. Okay, just keep on writing what I'm saying. Just write it in your words, of course, in a better words. There should be an awareness, there should be a peaceful opinion building. Peaceful opinion building. Okay. And all the other stakeholders that are there, like the civil societies, the NGOs, the religious institutions, because they also have a big impact on the people opinion. Okay. They also should together join hands to spread awareness. Okay. There should be redoubled efforts for permanent, peaceful, and political solutions. Okay. Where union government should mediate. And the output of this decision should be binding on all the parties and all the places. Okay. Also, we need to promote cross cultural interactions. We need to promote the cross-cultural interactions, and we should also improve the other things, like we need to just not give a differential treatment to the capital cities and the outskirt cities, because most of these disputes are there from the fact that people are not given equal opportunities of development. Okay, like there is a kind of differential treatment if we talk about the infrastructure. Okay, so in the capitals you will be finding good infrastructure and every proper sanitation, proper things like water supply, good food, everything is there. Okay, but when you move 10 20 kilometer away from the capital, you would discover that people are not even having proper clothes to wear. So we need to make sure that there shouldn't be any differential development, and development should be equal in all the parts. Okay, in order to make them even grow and develop as an individual, they should their rights should be protected. Okay. And one more thing, as we discussed in bilateral also, the Act East policy of India, Act East policy could also come into play here. Okay, it could also come into play here where we can, Northeast is basically the doorway to the eastern countries. Okay, so we should implement this policy here also, so that it is going to open the window for other possibilities also. So we need to act very very you know, there should be a proper, literally redoubled efforts to make this thing happen and to make sure that there is peace in these areas, okay? Because this is a grave concern for the internal security, okay? So that was it for this video. I'm going to discuss in the next video, as I already told you, about Nagaland. It is a big, you know, a big topic. I'm going to go in depth in Nagaland because it is basically the point of the most prominent insurgency activities, underground activities. We're going to talk about Nagaland and all the insurgency issue. We are also going to talk about all those agreements we talked about, 9 point, 16 point and all, okay? Everything is going to be covered in that only. So we'll be taking Nagaland basically in the next video lecture, and then we'll talk about the remaining issues, okay? Then we'll come to Jammu and Kashmir finally. So this was it for this video. I hope you liked this and understood it well, okay? If you did, just leave a like, share it with your friends who need it, and please subscribe to this channel. This is very important for us, okay? It doesn't take more than a second or two. Just go and subscribe. It gives us motivation. It lets us know that yes, you are benefiting from it and you are understanding it and you want more of these lectures, okay? So thank you so much for being here, and till then, bye bye, take care and stay safe.